Better late than never. We are starting from somewhere. As I speak to you now, somebody has approached me on using the braille to help the sight challenged ones, which from here I'm going to look at it and see how best I'll teach you so that you can also handle them. Amen. No, we want to climb every mountain, descend every valley, walk every plain, so the gospel is preached to all and all. Amen. Good. So there's a special brother, special papa, special somebody. He loves the work so much, and he has developed the language, the sign language, to minister to the hearing impaired in a very wonderful way with the gospel. He's here with us. Thank you. So without much ado, let me invite to the podium, or to the lectern, yes, this one to the lectern, Mr. Gabriel. Hello. Can we show some love? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. Shall we pray?
Or the professionals the medical proponents, those nurses and all that, they look at deafness as a disease. They look at they emphasize on the pathological aspects. And pathology tells you that deals with diseases, their nature, causes, and symptoms. But we have another aspect, another group of people who see deafness as just a social difference. There's nothing wrong with them. For me, somebody who is deaf, there's nothing wrong with him. You might see him as deaf, but I don't see that person as deaf. I just see him as his language is different from my language. That is it. Hallelujah. And some of these things, if you don't know, you will just shun them. But we need them. It is just a linguistic difference. What can say and what can say no yes from God? But that does not mean you are better off than me. No. That's why a big no. So that is why we use the capital T. Because we see ourselves in a unique community. They have their own community. And just go and find yourself in their community. You will see that you are misfits. Just like when they are in your community, you see them as they are misfits. You too, come to a deaf environment, a deaf community, and you see that you are a misfit there. We can talk and then you stand there and watch that. And then they're having their own life. You are a misfit. So what makes you think you are special than them? They are even special. That's why you have special needs. They are special. There are other people who are special. Reaching out to every child on race. This is from Darren. Now, we had a connectional workshop, connectional heritage directory workshop as Sorbonne. My brother was there, he just wrote my teaching. And Professor Ebusei Isin was there. He was one of the facilitators. So I went and asked him a very simple question. That what role did people with special needs play as far as the propagation of the gospel is concerned?
And you know what he said? What role, as far as our church is concerned, as far as the propagation of the gospel is concerned? And then you know the answer he gave. He said, I'm quoting you. He said, we in this church, referring to our Methodist church, Ghana, we in this church have candidated a successful minister who is visually impaired. And he just gave me the relief. Oh, I love my church. A successful minister who is visually impaired. And he didn't mention the name as Reverend Amonifo or something like that. And then he added, the man was nice. He said he went through all the system, quarterly ministry, they approved him, and then he went to Trinity. Visually impaired. It means we have been doing more. Look, our church has been doing more. And I said, wow. I'm in a good church. They say I'm a special, I have to do that. Thank you very much. I hope you can see me from this angle. Thank you. Thank you, Director. Okay, now I can see all the applicants. And because we didn't necessarily
hide it. It was as if the church is dormant. And I thank the director for this program. It has always been my prayer that we find a way to reach people like that. And if we are reaching them, why are we reaching them? We are reaching them because of the gospel. So I have to sit down and then try and design something for those people. Now, I realize that this is not the first time, or this is not now that we are doing something like that. We have been doing it, but we don't know that this is what we are doing. So looking at sign language and the gospel, I found out that most of the action songs we sing in our Sunday school contain something in sign language we call non-verbal markers. Non-verbal markers. Jesus. And then suddenly he sang this. I said, hey, he didn't want to know what I was doing. I was still doing my research. I was gathering some more information. Mr. Pastor. This is Jesus that is sweet. And what you did at the 21st International Sunday. Okay, I'm saying it so that you do the actions. Okay, ready? Go. Jesus' love is sweet and wonderful. Jesus' love is sweet and wonderful. Jesus' love is sweet and wonderful. Oh, oh, wonderful love. Okay, what? Thank you. What is just this? Let's have a conversation. Mr. Panser at the International Children's Festival came and did the sign. I said, wow! And then I went to you and said, Mr. Panser, so we are saying Jesus love, and then you do this. So what is it? He said, this is the sign language for Jesus. And that is it, it's the truth. That is Jesus. And then another sign, the wonderful. But you see, we combine the signs. These are some of the manual markers I want to show you, which is in the manual that you are holding. These are some of the non-manual markers that are in the sign language. But we have combined it with other things that any understand any chassis. For example, the sweet, you did sweet like this. But in sign language, you don't do sweet like this. If something is sweet, I'd like it. So we do it. This is sweet. Do you get it? But we have join the sweet with the Jesus, which is correct, and then, but we have been using it. But you give them, this is what we are doing. So we need to expose ourselves so that when we meet people who are deaf, we can, or we will be able to communicate with them meaningfully. If you sign Jesus, the deaf person will know that, oh, this is Jesus. But if you do the deaf, so what is that? What is this? You might not, the communication, there will be a gap there. So for instance, if you have added sweet, then you realize that, okay, Jesus is sweet. So that's why we have to expose ourselves to it, so that you really know what we are doing. So I said, most of the gospel action songs we sing in our Sunday schools contain non-verbal markers in sign language. It is therefore not out of place to understand the meaning of these non-verbal markers to enable us to have a conventional communication with the dead in order to share the gospel with them. The fourth question. In the January-June 2018 weekly Bible lesson, I picked it from the weekly Bible lesson, page 27 of the guest ended weekly Bible lesson, and then page 72, right up, and then it was the discussion question was asking us to discuss the all inclusiveness of the church in relation to the great commission. Discuss the all inclusiveness of the church in relation to the great commission.